In a prior video, I showed you how to install anaerobic connectors on 900 micron coated fiber, or tight buffered fiber. Well, the process is exactly the same, with the exception of a few steps for installing anaerobic connectors on jacketed cables such as this. Well, I have a couple of tools here, and I do have some safety glasses. You also need adequate ventilation whenever you're working with anaerobic connectors, and if you're working with vast quantities of these, you might need rubber gloves. Starting with my two cards here, I have the LC on the left and the SDSE on the other side here. I'm going to make sure that the ends of my cable are even using a pair of snips, after which I'm going to start with my 1.6 millimeter jacketed cable and using the right card, because I'm going to be installing an LC connector on that end, I'm going to make two marks, one at the 28 millimeter mark and one at the 35 millimeter point. I'm going to do the same thing with my 3.9 and 2.9 millimeter jacketed cable, but this time I'm going to make a mark at the 22 millimeter point and 32 millimeter point. For the SD connector, those marks are 28 millimeters and 38 millimeters. Using a buffer stripping tool, remove the jacketing at the mark closest to the end of the jacket. For 1.6 millimeter, use the 20 gauge, and for the 2 millimeter, use the 18 gauge, and for the 2.9 millimeter, use the 16 gauge. And then remove the jacket. No sliding motion, you may damage the fiber on the inside. After this point, remove the aramid yarn using a pair of snips, and then use the buffer stripping tool to remove the jacketing at the second mark. I've arranged my connectors here to show how everything is going to work. This is the 900 micron boot. We're definitely not doing this. And since we're doing 1.6 millimeters on this, I'm not going to need the 2.9 millimeter boot. And the same thing goes on this end. This boot here will work for 1.6 and 2 millimeter cables. We are doing 2.9 on this particular one. So I have everything I need. I will install my boot now, but really you should install the boot right before you start with the measuring steps, because it makes life a little bit easier, but it was easy for demonstration. And then we're gonna use the crimp band to hold back the aramid yarn on both. And as you can see from this, the narrow end is back. You might need to maneuver that a little bit to get it in place, just like that. So at this point, I will make two marks from the end of the cable here. And that is 17 millimeters for the LC, and SC that I'm installing, that is 18 millimeters. If you're installing an SD connector, then mark your fiber at 20 millimeters. After this point, I'm going to use my miller strippers and I'm going to strip off that section. I'm using a dual hole miller strippers. So this is a 2-point action here. At this point, my connectors should look just like they do on the cards, and I will clean my fiber and install the anaerobic and adhesive inside the connectors, and then we'll resume from there. I've trimmed my fiber. For details on how to do that, please review our video on installing anaerobic connectors on 900 micron coated fibers. The video also details how to polish after installing the crimping bands. So slide the crimping band back and then flare the fiber around the threaded area of the connector, and then slide the crimp band over. Do the same thing for the LC, and now we're ready to crimp. For the LC, use the orange tool. Notice the holes A, B, and C. It's the same thing on the blue crimping tool. The A's work for 2.9 millimeter, B's for 2.0 and 1.6, and then C for 1.6. So I'm going to be using the C hole because I'm installing the connector on 1.6 millimeter, and then crimp the band just like that, release, and your jacket is strain relieved. Next, you're going to slide the boot up, and we're almost ready to polish. You can also at this point insert the trigger if you're working with LCs, just like that. For the SC and ST, we use a blue tool, and since we are working on 2.9 millimeter jacket, I'm going to install it just like that on the A. The tool releases once the crimp is all the way, so that should look just like that. And then slide the boot. We're now ready to polish. At any point during fiber preparation, if your fiber doesn't look like the graphics provided on the card, please start over. If you have any other questions, please give us a call or send us an email at cablesystems@corning.com. And remember, Corning Cable Systems recommends getting training fiber optic installation. We offer a series of classes, of course, and we thank you.